Good afternoon. All right, I am coming to talk with you about McGuffey's Eclectic readers. So I have this entire set here. This video was a request, a subscriber request. So I'm just going to kind of go through, read through a little bit of the books and just give a nice overview and kind of let you know thoughts and how we use them and things like that. If you're not familiar with McGuffey readers, they are old school. I love old school. You all know me. Just old, just classic. They're from the 1840s, somewhere between 1840, 1960s. And, you know, I teach my children to read, or help them learn to read phonetically. Phonetically is, it's been very successful, and, it's just pretty much the best way to teach them. I don't teach them by sight because it's, not a good basis. You're only teaching, if you're using sight words, you're only teaching them sight words, and they will not be able to decode anything past that sight word to the point where they can memorize a sight word. That's why they're called sight words. But to teach them from sight words is not a good basis. I use the fry word method, and I've done a video. It was a request as well, March 2016 fry word list. It's about 85-90% those words of the English language, everyday English language, and so they're going to come across those words more than sight words. Sight words they will run across in just everyday reading, so that's the reason why I don't spend time teaching them. I never have, and my children have read from the age of 3. They have read fluently after using Hooked on Phonics, the original version. So, I think 4 years old, they were reading chapter books as such. So, like I said, phonetics is the best method. In the McGuffey readers, there are explanations given in the text that are enough to get started, you know, to help a child, teach a child to read and write. Okay, there's what they call slate work, and that's copy work. It's usually not recommended to teach a child to read and write at the same time. Most programs recommend starting with reading. If you're starting before age 5, start with the reading. Don't push the writing until 5, 5 and a half-ish, 6, because they are not really developmentally ready, and it can frustrate them and hinder their reading. But there is copy work in here, and as a bonus, they will learn Roman numerals. The weakness in these books is they teach words and sounds together. Okay, typically I teach my children sounds from the time they are 18 months, 2.5 years old, because they've already learned the alphabet from age 0 to 18 months. And we work on the sounds from that point. These teach the words and the sounds. So I would not recommend starting a child that has no history of, you know, reading. I would not recommend these because they're very meaty. And they can be quite overwhelming to a parent, let alone a child, if your children are not fans of literature. I also would not recommend them because they're literature based. They're not cartoony, they're not fun, they can be quite boring, in my opinion. Okay, my children like literature. I like literature, so they're not boring to us, but I could easily see how they can become boring. So yeah, the letters and sounds, a child could easily memorize. They could be memorizing the words instead of phonetically learning the way this program is set up. Only a few words are introduced at a time and they're given before the lesson. And that could also make it difficult for efficient reading. It could make, you know, the process long and tedious just to get through a lesson or, you know, the book. I found that hooked on phonics, the children are progressing very rapidly, and in a week's time they went from not reading a single thing to reading an early reader and a couple of chapters in a chapter book. So this, you won't get that result. It's also missing some of the sounds. Like for the letter A, there's only 6 sounds given, but there's actually 9 sounds. So if you have, those are things that you have to teach. You can have it. But by the first lesson, the child will have read about 300 words, and the average child of any age, they say, completes this program in 30 to 60 hours of instruction. So like I said, if your child becomes frustrated and not being able to progress, or they're having trouble, it's going to take longer. And they could be reading other things. That's what I was saying about hooked on phonics. Once they go through that half of the first book, they're already reading. And they're reading anything. It's just that simple. That it's very efficient. But as a supplement to give them meaty things, right here. So first up, you have, I have the spelling book. In the spelling book, you will get and it tells you what it's about. Talks about your alphabet, English alphabet, vowels, diphthongs, trithongs, or triphthongs. Here you get your, in each of the books, you will get the table of vocals. The long sound, the short sounds, sub vocals, and the aspirates. Okay? I know some of you might be lost right here. Table of substitutes, consonants, the mutes. Okay? When using programs like this, it's very important to understand this part before you go into the other part. And that's mainly why so many parents have a hard time with reading curriculum, because they fail to start here. They just open the book and let's start reading. I see that a lot with Teach a Child to Read in 100 Easy Lessons. The majority of the parents did not read what they said, because I'm watching how they are teaching the children, and it clearly gives you instruction. And everybody basically does the same thing. They just open the book and say, let's start reading. And so that child ends up in tears, and that book always ends up on the shelf. So you will see script alphabet, capital letters, lowercase. You will get manuscript. You will get your pictorial alphabet. Like I said, the pictures are really, you know, it's black and white. Then look at the typeset. That's what makes them stand out. Let me get your numbers. And so you get your first lesson, short sounds of vowels, am, and, as, at, ax, rap, sat. You're getting all of the short A vowel sounds in one. Could be pretty confusing because it's jumping from sound to sound. And I'm going to go back and compare this to hooked on phonics. When looking at hooked on phonics, they're introduced to one sound at a time. And they get it after reading am, pam, sam. Okay, here they're going from am to at, app. Okay, and so they either know the sounds really well and they can pick it up like that, or you're going to spend more time just on first lesson. The rest of them will continue like this in the spelling book. Okay, so if that's a problem, again, you can, it's still not, you can still use them. Introduce it after the child is reading fluently so as to not confuse them. Okay, if it were just bad, mad, pad, sad, is there any more rad on one line, that would be okay. But here it's all mixed up. Even though it is the short A sound, the sounds are all mixed up. Okay, and it continues like that for each of the vowel sounds. They're not necessarily in order. Here's lesson 4. You've moved into the silent E, the double E, the long A, the long O, so on. Here's lesson 20. You're moving into blends. And it's actually double blends because you have the blend in the front and the blend in the back. Again, they're not in any particular order, so it can be kind of confusing working out of just a spelling book. You just kind of back here to a lesson 116, and back here to lesson 238, names of women, names of men, and at lesson 247. Okay. Geographical regions, states, and then lesson 248, the characters of punctuation. There we go. So let me move on. And like I said, that's just a spelling book. So the first reader, you can see there are various pages in these books. You get your preface. You get suggestions to the teacher. And your alphabet, your script, script figures. All right. Here's your instruction telling you how to pronounce dog, the, ran. And get your vowel sounds. The dog ran. OK. Okay, so they have to know the sounds before you even pick this book up. Cat, Matt is on the cat. Is the cat on the mat? The cat is on the mat. The man has a pen. Is the pen in his hand? It is in his hand. The pictures are not very bright, so they don't, it's not impossible, but it's not a, you look at the picture and get an idea. It's a little bit harder in these books. Okay, Rab and Hat Catch. See Rab, see Ann, see Rab, Ann has the hat. Can Ann catch Rab? Okay, now we're reading about Ned. And one thing I want to point out is I just read catch, okay? The CH blend very quickly is introduced. For a very young one, 4 years old, they have to have already known that and able to read that. Okay, a lot of reading curriculums do this. They will throw in these blends and the child has not even been taught. Again, teach a child to read in 100 lessons does the same thing. And I know that is why a lot of parents and children get frustrated, because it's throwing in these blends, CH and CK, and they have not even taught how to teach that yet. Okay, you get black. They have to already know the blend. TH. The first blend they will learn is TH, because they're going to learn the word the. You have SH. And usually the is the first blend a child will learn and know for a long time. Because that's just pretty much how they can process it, and at the, you know, the speed that they are learning, unless you have very quick readers. My children did do it, and that was with the help of Hooked on Phonics. Had I used something else, I don't think they would have been able to decode as fast as they did. I remember reading myself as a child. I read at 3, and I was reading Go Bob, Go Dog Go, The Fire Cat, those kind of books. There was no particular reading program. Okay, so here we have, you know, your lesson, your instruction. Your Roman numerals are up here. Then you get your slate work. That's the copy work. Okay, of course, they're not going to be able to do script, manuscript, or cursive script writing, but they can do print work once they're learning how to write. Ned is on the box. He has a pen in his hand. A big rat is in the box. Can the dog catch the rat? Come with me, Anne, and see the man on the black hat with a black hat on his head. The fat hen has left the nest. Run, Nat, and get the eggs. Okay, so not really a whole lot of, I mean, there is a little, you know, it makes a little sense, but not really. Okay, so if that bothers your child, again, these would not be a good fit. Let me move you into another lesson. Let's see where they start to get a little bit longer. Say lesson. Here's one. So you see the wording starts to get longer. No, they were really short, because here's lesson right here. Here's the end of it, and then it moves on to this one. And then we have a whole page. And copy work. So they're getting progressively longer. I'll just move back here. You know what? I'm going to set this down for just a second. get towards the back and kind of show you how things kind of change up. Okay. How does the bird make the nest so strong, Willie? The mother bird has her bill with her claws to work with, but she would not know how to make the nest if God did not teach her. Do you see what it is made of? Yes, Willie. I see some horse hairs and some dry grass. The old bird must have worked hard to find the hairs, all the hairs, and make them into such pretty round nests. Shall we take the nest, Rose? Oh, no, Willie, we must not take it. But we will come and look at it again sometime. Here's your copy work. God made the little birds to sing. And flit from the tree, flit from tree to tree. Tis he who sends them in the spring to sing for you and me. Okay, let me see somebody's bookmark is here. But this is what you're working with. And I'm just going to turn to the last lesson in this book. And I'm going to show you that real quick. So here's the last lesson in this book. So if you come to the last lesson, we have finished the first reader. And you see the typeset got a little bit bigger. Now you can read all the lessons in it, and you can write them on your slate. And then you get your phonetic chart back here, your diphthongs, and all that good stuff back there. Okay. So I'm just going to go through quickly, because they're all set up the same way. Just kind of give you how book two starts. There you go. This is what you're looking at. One lesson. I mean, my kids do enjoy them because they're fairly simple. One, two pages. And it gives them diversity in reading. So they do enjoy reading them. They know that they can read from here one or two lessons versus a chapter book. And I'm fine with it because of the type of reading that they're doing. Twinkle, twinkle, little star. Okay. We'll get back to the last lesson in this book. It's a lullaby. So you get some poetry and things like that in here. Sweet and low, wind of the western sea. Low, low, breathe and blow, wind of the western sea. Over the rolling waters, come from the dying moon and blow. Blow him again to me, while my little one, while my pretty one sleeps. This is from Tennyson. So they get two verses. Yes, Alfred Lord Tennyson. This is what I said about the literary side of it. My children do enjoy literature, so these are fine for them. All right, we're right here through book three. And just kind of, hold on. I didn't think this would be as difficult, but obviously, all right here. So you get your beginning exercises here. And a little bit about punctuation and emphasis. Here you see the typeset is smaller. This is the third reader. Okay, it's broken up, and you can have them read all of it, or say, let's go one through three today. You know, sometimes we would do 1 through 3 in the morning, 4 through 6 in the afternoon, 7 through 10 in the evening, that type of thing. Because it can be quite long for some. So this is what I was saying about it could take a long time. And these words are words that my children already know. If we were just reading through here, they would not know these words. If we were just using this program, but they already know these words. All right, so I'm going to move you to the back and just kind of run you through. It's a lesson on John Carpenter. Another poem. Picture. So you see, this is still John Carpenter. It's quite long. And that's about 3 pages. Okay, I'll take you to the last one. In here. This one is called Good Night. It's a poem. Looks like my lens is dirty. Okay. The sun is hidden from our sight. The birds are sleeping sound. 'Tis time to say all good night and give a kiss all around. So again, you can use this for copy work. And we are in the fourth reader out of 6. And yes, the words are getting smaller. Okay. What's that? Fourth reader. And can easily find these books on Amazon, eBay, and I will leave a link where you can download these for absolutely zero ebook. And that will give you a good idea. You know, you get a good look at them that way, and you can determine if you would like to buy them. But generally, check eBay. Try to get a set under $20 if you can. Why the Sea is Salt. The rich man was ill-natured and he heard his brother's request. He looked very surly. But as Christmas is time when the worst people give gifts, he took a fine ham down from the chimney where it was hanging to smoke, threw it at his brother, and bade him be gone and never let him see his face again. Okay, so very heavy literature. Okay, and these, the later the book, the more pages, the more pages.
I knew it went there.
Yes, the more lessons. All right. Sorry about that. A Mother's Gift of the Bible is what this one ends on. Bear with me. I'm trying to give a good enough look because I know I've seen plenty of these, and the looks of, you know, look or walkthrough, they weren't as complete. And as this is a request, I just want to make sure that the person is satisfied. Bonaparte. Death of Franklin. Hamlet. So you're easily up into middle school, you know, with this, these levels. The good readers, Frederick the Great, King of Prussia. Not too many pictures in here once they get to the upper books, but still enough. The Fate, Francis Bret Harte. And honestly, I don't know anybody that has, you know, I've seen many people talk about them and say they use them. I've not seen anybody this far and still talking about them. So, yeah. Yeah, we have used them, and my children do like them. So, and sometimes I sit down and read to them. You know, I always read everything I give my children, and I like to read them myself. So this is the sixth and final reader. Okay, you get the inflections and things like that. Some samples. Trying to get to the first lesson. Way over here. Hold on. Just pretty much, oh, I just passed the first lesson, tells you about, this is more the, gives you a lot more grammar. Okay, first one right here, the King of Spain. Needle. Such was the glorious spectacle as I entered the train. As we proceeded, the timid approach of the twilight became more perceptible. The intense blue of the sky began to soften. The smaller stars, the little children, went first to rest. The sister beams of the Pleiades soon melted together. Looking at that baby next to me. But the bright constellation of the west and north remained unchanged. So yeah, and then you get your notes down here. Edward Everett, 1794-1865. Again, this would make for, I mean, you can do all sorts of things with this. Memory, recitation, copy work. Yeah, but like I said, keep in mind the nature of this type of reading program. It is very heavy literature based. So it's not, I mean, I know it says it's helpful to teach a child how to read, but if they're not into this type of reading. So there's the last page. Now you get a lot of grammar and a lot of you know, the language arts part of this in here. So that is an upside to this. Samuel Taylor Coleridge. Gives you a little bio of him. So hopefully this was helpful. If you have any further questions, leave me a comment. Like I said, look for the link in the description box. If I happen to forget it, please leave me a comment. But you can download these ebooks for free. Be blessed and enjoy. Back of them. So, give you an example.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, they can be pretty pricey if you let them, but check around on eBay and try to find from one seller. Bye!